Okay, how many times have you heard this? Breakfast is the most important meal of the day. Well, it's true. But you know what? If you're busy, you don't always have time. Well, I have a super simple breakfast recipe just for you that is going to last all week long, and you can use it on the go. Love this idea. Okay, first of all, here's what you're going to need. You're going to need some wax paper, some cheese. I'm using low-fat mozzarella cheese. You're going to need some, I'm using multi-grain flour tortillas, chicken breasts. Now, you can buy this already pre-made. There's a lot of salt in it. I personally prefer grilling my own chicken and using it. But you know what? If you're busy and you don't have time, this is a good alternative. Some salsa and, of course, some eggs. And that's what I have right here already cooked up. Now, what I used are egg beaters, okay? You can use real eggs, or you can even use egg whites if you want to go really super healthy. But here's how this works. I've got my tortillas warming. Now, this is important to do this because if you don't warm your tortillas, taking them out of the refrigerator, they become really stiff and they're going to break when you roll them up. So I've laid out a whole bunch of sheets of wax paper. I'm making five, okay? I'm going to put out my tortilla, and then I'm going to spoon out some of my egg beater, about a quarter cup, I believe. Enough to kind of just, you know, fill it up because I'm going to put some other stuff in there. Okay, that looks really good. I did not add any salt to this at all. Okay, now I'm going to add a little bit of cheese. I like to set up a workstation so that everything's right here and it's ready to go. And my chicken. I cut these up because they came in pretty big chunks, so I cut them up so that I could roll them up really nice. Okay, that looks about right. And then my favorite part, salsa. You can use any other type of salsa that you like, or you could even use like a barbecue sauce or whatever. Okay, just like that. Now, do you know how to roll a burrito? Well, let me show you. First of all, you're going to put the end in just like that, and you're going to take your burrito and you're going to roll it just like that. Now, it's a pretty big burrito, but that's okay because here's the trick. Roll it up nice and tight with the wax paper. Boom, there you go. Goes in the fridge. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to make five of these, and then I put them in the fridge. But here's the trick. When you cook your breakfast burritos, you can use all kinds of ingredients. Now, the eggs give you lots and lots of protein, and the cheese is just really good, but you don't have to use mozzarella cheese. Here's a great idea. Try this. The Laughing Cow garlic and herb gives it a really nice flavor. If you have any leftover potatoes, any baked potatoes, you can cut those up. You can add some garlic if you want a different tone or different flavor. And here's what I have left over, some salmon. So I could even add some salmon to my breakfast burrito. But for now, I'm going to use my chicken. And once again, a little bit of salsa. Yummy. Roll it up. Just like that. Use your wax paper. Put a nice tight grip on it. Roll that up. Okay. Now, if you use leftovers, it's really important to mark the burrito. And the reason why is because I've already had the salmon in the refrigerator for about 2 days. So if I'm going to use any leftovers, you want to make sure that you eat your burritos at the beginning of the week. So let's pretend this one had a leftover in it. So I'm just going to mark it Monday. And let's pretend this one had leftovers in it. I'm going to mark it Tuesday. And that way I know to eat those burritos first. And you could make five of them and be ready. All you have to do is grab a burrito, walk out the door. When you're ready to eat it, you toss it in the microwave for about 40 seconds and you are good to go. Okay, but here's the best part, you guys. Using the ingredients that I showed you, okay, let me give you an idea of how healthy these are. Okay, first of all, one burrito, 370 calories, 11 grams of fat, 26 grams of carbohydrates, 39 grams of protein, and here's the part that I'm not excited about, 1,500 milligrams of salt, but that's only because I'm using the pre-packaged chicken. You know, doing something super simple doesn't always mean that it's cheaper or that it's better for you. So just keep that in mind. But I'll tell you what, regardless, this is definitely super simple cooking.